Deputy Murphy.
Thank you, Ken Corlett. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. This is the situation facing the government now, Taoiseach. You're at that moment between pride and a fall. Faced with a huge protest on Saturday, faced with the prospect of a massive boycott, all the talk of listening has now been forgotten. It's replaced by a high-handed, arrogant and bullying approach. Minister Kelly is swaggering around the place like Nelson from The Simpsons, threatening to rob people's lunch money. Housing agencies are sending threatening letters to their tenants. We have yet another, a fifth deadline of Irish Water, taking all meaning away from the word deadline, designed to frighten people, because despite what they say, they're not happy about the level of registration. And we face quite an incredible situation, weeks before bills going out, whereby the government is threatening that Irish Water will be able to deduct from people's wages, benefits or pensions. It isn't doing so by putting a bill before the House or raising it for debate in the House. It isn't even doing so by going on the airwaves to put this forward and to debate it. It's doing so through leaks in the media designed to strike fear into people right across the country. Is this the new way of doing politics? Is this the democratic revolution that's sitting on an overburdened shelf of forgotten promises? People deserve clarity here, not more waffle, and I'm asking the Taoiseach to answer these questions very, very clearly. One, when will we be seeing this long-promised bill? Two, can he confirm that water charges are not a revenue tax and that therefore the powers of revenue to deduct simply do not apply? Three, can he further confirm that any move to give Irish Water those powers would mean Irish Water falling foul of the Eurostat market corporation test? Fourthly, if there was any move to bring in a fast-tracked court procedure, which would require one court case rather than a multiple to get an attachment of earnings order, wouldn't that have to similarly apply to other utility companies?
Thank you.
How on earth will he deal with the hundreds of thousands who will refuse to pay? How many hundreds of new judges will the state be appointing? How many scores of new courthouses will the state be building? Or will the entire system simply be blocked up?
Thank you, Deputy. Therefore, I'll finish on this. Thank you.
Isn't Elizabeth Arnett of Irish Water correct when she said this morning, for the first four bills, there will be no penalties? People can therefore refuse to pay with no penalties until after the next...
Thank you, Deputy.
They can join the network in bidding their bills outside the doll on
Saturday, the 18th of April. Deputy, you're over time. Would you please adhere to the truth? Thank you.
It will sink Irish Water and it will sink your government.
Taoiseach.
Taoiseach.
The Minister for...
The
Minister for the Environment will bring his proposals to Cabinet in the next few weeks. The Cabinet will consider these proposals and make decisions about them. The bill will then be published and put through the Dáil and the Seanad. The bill will deal with the questions that the Deputy has raised. I want to say that I think it's not good for you or for anybody else in here to put out a view that you can put people in a position where they're building up a debt for the future. The government have listened very carefully to what the people have said and have introduced a level of charging for water that we think is fair and is affordable. And it's not a good thing, Deputy Murphy, to say to people, put off this and build up a debt as a consequence. I think there's a sense of fairness here that you don't seem to realise. The vast majority of people who have signed up as customers of Irish Water and who will continue to sign up as Irish Water customers want to know that their neighbours, including you, will make their contribution for the production of quality Irish water in the coming years. So your questions about courts and all of these matters will be dealt with in the bill to be produced by the government following its decision in regard to the minister's propositions. There's a need for compliance here, Deputy Murphy, a need for people to understand that there will be equality in that compliance, and that everybody who can pay should pay and will pay. In that sense, the bill will come before the House inside a matter of weeks, and people will have their opportunity to discuss and debate it. We've gone beyond the point, Deputy Murphy, of not facing into this. The country has to deal with it, and I'm very heartened by the continuing strong support in registrations for people signing up to what they know is a precious commodity, and one that we have to be able to supply to every person in the country, not just in particular locations.
Thank you.
So the bill will be introduced in a few weeks' time, Mr. Corlett.
Thank you. Deputy Murphy, thank you.
Thank you. Firstly, in relation to the promised bill, so the Taoiseach tells us that it will be coming in the next few weeks. On the 3rd of February, he told us it will be coming in the next couple of weeks. So will the next time we raise this, will it be coming in the next couple of months to be followed by the next few months? It's a bill that simply never appears because the government wants to use it to scare people, and the content will be a lot less scary. If it does include a procedure for fast-tracking non-payers of water charges through the courts, does the Taoiseach not consider that there are many more people in the state who should be in front of non-payers in the queue? Serious criminals and those who are actually responsible for the economic crisis in this state for which people are paying through water charges. Secondly, in relation to the vast majority signing up to water charges, I noticed the Taoiseach didn't give figures. The figures coming out from the government...
Sorry, would you put your question? You have 1 minute
sure.
to do it. Thank you.
I want to ask about how many people have signed up, because the only consistent message is that lots have signed up. But on Monday morning, Minister Kelly told us that 1.23 million had signed up, and that was an increase of 130,000 over the past 4 weeks. Last night, we heard we're around 1.23, but that's 120,000 increased over the past 7 weeks.
Thank you.
On the government's motion, they refer to 1.237 million households have responded, right? But we have an answer from Irish Water from 1 month ago.
This is question
referring
time.
To 1.2 3 million. So an increase
question
of
figures,
an increase
you
of 8,000 over
Thank
the past
you.
Month. What are the accurate figures? The final supplementary question, Kevin Corla.
Sorry, Deputy, do you understand you have 1 minute for the supplementary?
I do.
You're now exactly
I also
2
understand.
Minutes. So would you put your question?
I do. I put the question.
It's not statements.
Can I finally ask, what consolation prize? What consolation prize is the Taoiseach going to give the Labour Party for enthusiastically hammering
Thank
the
you.
Final nails in their coffin? Will they take the chance?
Thank
Will
you.
The Taoiseach?
Sorry. Thank you, Taoiseach.
From the Anti-Austerity Alliance tonight to abolish water charges.
Taoiseach. In respect of an earlier question that you asked, Deputy, I do expect that the. Market corporation test will be passed by Irish Water. That, as you know, is a matter for an independent analysis by Eurostat. The bill will be published very shortly after Easter. And in respect of your last comment, this is a government comprised of Fine Gael and the Labour Party, handed a mandate by the people to deal with the most difficult situation economically that our country's ever had. And for that reason, government have faced the many difficult choices to be made and made decisions. As you understand, Deputy Murphy, commentators are entitled to commentate. But politics is about people and government is about making decisions. I'm not sure that you have arrived at that point yet. If it ever comes your way, in whatever form, you will find you live in a very different space than you are now.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.